So today I'm going to talk about Lyme disease that maybe is very common for most of you, but in this case, in a specific population, the Hispanic immigrants, workers in Long Island. So here is the map. This is the map of the Center of Disease Control and Prevention of the United States, 2018. As you can see, several cases, and Long Island is here. But the most important, 300,000 cases per year. And this is official numbers. You remember that usually official numbers are not, you know, as higher as the real life is, you know? And so, but what's Lyme disease? Lyme disease is caused by a bacteria. It's a bacterial infection. If this is the bacteria, okay? But where is the bacteria? In the nature? Yes, it's in the nature, but it's living in these animals. This is the most important. This is a mouse, a wide-footed mouse. This is very common in Long Island, okay? But it needs an environment. And we have in Suffolk County, in Long Island, the best environment, okay? And so the next player is the tick, because the tick is going to be infected when he's going to feed on this mouse. He takes the bacteria. And so then the next is the interaction with the human. Tick bite, infection. That's the point. Okay, so that's because the environment, the outdoor activities, outdoor occupation are risky. But how risky they are? The books, when you read the paper, said, oh, this is risky, outdoor occupation, but we need to measure because all the data is very old, you know? It's very old, the data, okay? So what happened after a tick bite? You develop, the person is going to develop a specific symptom. It's a problem for the doctor. Fever, malaise, headache, You okay, what do you have? Flu disease? We don't know. But what happens if you develop these signs in the skin? Oh, it's easy for the physician. Lyme disease, it may be 80 or 90% of the cases is true, okay? But what's the problem? Not 100% of the patients develop these signs. For example, in our study, only 30% of the cases, they develop this sign. So they report it, okay? So in other studies, 50%, 60%, so that's a problem. If not treated the disease in that moment, in the early, what happens? Okay, problems, long-term problems. Joint pains, headache for a long time. And people, they don't know, they are suffering. That's the problem, okay? So, but why did we decide to work in this area? Because Long Island, Suffolk County, is endemic for Lyme disease, okay? But what the next? Oh, these people. Oh, that's interesting. In this landscape, these people are working so much. Hispanic population are more likely to work in this outdoor occupation. I say, oh, maybe they have more susceptibility. Maybe what's the risk, the real risk? We wanted to measure that. That we did, okay? In this area, how did we do that? So with the support of the community organization, also educational organization. For example, here, this is BOSIS. BOSIS is a state organization for education, you know? Here, for example, this is an English class for Hispanics. So we offered an Spanish lecture for prevention in Lyme disease. After that, we invite the people to invite to the study, informed consent, the survey, and blood draw, okay? Okay? And what did we found in this study? It's very interesting because that's some of the findings. You know, for example, this is for me, one of the most important findings, you know? 75%, they don't have health insurance. So what does it mean? Undocumented. That's a real, real problem. No, okay. And then the income, annual income. Okay, look at this, elementary school, 59%. So they don't know, most of them, they don't know how to write, how to read, okay? And also Spanish, they 90% feel uncomfortable receiving information in English. All the problems we have here, okay? There is a barrier for the prevention and healthcare access. Also, we found statistically that if you work as a gardener, landscaper, you have two times the risk for getting infected with Lyme disease, okay? So what's the next? But we have an opportunity, because why? 90% of these persons, they use a smartphone. So what's the next step for us? The next step, I'm sorry for that, is that we want to develop education, but not in the traditional way. So using these tools, and that we are looking for partners. Thank you for your time.